Hi, this is Travis Sabin, Product Manager for Adobe Analytics. And today, in this video, we're going to do a deeper dive into the custom dimension cohort in the new cohort table in Analysis Workspace. So let's say I am a multinational media company, and we use targeted campaigns to drive users to various platforms to drive engagement. Ad spend is absolutely critical, and so I want to make sure I know which campaigns are performing best. And in order to do that, I'm going to come into the new cohort table in Analysis Workspace, and I'm going to build a quick cohort here with, I just want to track visits, and then I want to see how that turns into online orders. I can quickly see that data and see how my visits are turning into online orders, but I want to know, like I said, which campaigns are driving the orders here. So I'm going to come back and open up the editing settings here in cohort table. I'm going to go to the advanced settings, and I'm going to click on custom dimension cohort, and I'm going to add campaign ID dimension. Once I add the campaign ID dimension, I'm going to build. I can see really quickly here that my natural search engine is performing really, really well. And my campaign DA10002-B and 10003-C are doing a great job of driving visitors and still keeping online orders coming day after day. They're not dropping out and falling off like these other campaigns are. These ones aren't doing a lot of driving repeat or online order traffic. So using this information, I can come in and identify the campaigns that I want to see. Okay, what is making 10002-B and 10003-C so effective? Why are they working as well as some of these other ones here at the bottom? And I want to take those learnings and apply them to my other campaigns and try and boost sales that way. So that's a great use case for the custom dimension cohort. We could replace campaign ID with product, with pages, or with any other dimension that is critical for side-by-side quick analysis over time.